Welcome to yet another Pemetic Purveyors video tour. This is Ryan. Today, we're in down East Maine, in the town of Danforth, having a look at an incredibly dynamic property. So dynamic that only video can display what's on offer. Let's get started, there's a lot to see. Our first viewpoint will show the end of road location that the home enjoys. Right behind where I'm filming is a locked gate which leads to over 3,000 acres of privately owned woodlands owned by the Baskegan Company. The owner of this property enjoys access to this outdoor oasis. Next is the rose garden right along the driveway. This is a 10 by 12 shed with a gravel patio and pergola over the roses. These are just starting to mature. Over the years, they'll blossom into quite a beautiful outdoor setting. And now we're overlooking the gardens, the garden house, you can see the potting shed, and a little horse run in there. We'll see a lot more of that later. Well, along the driveway, we're getting our first close look at the home, which is a plantation-style home, modeled after Ernest Hemingway's house in Key West, Florida. Way, way far away from Danforth, that's for sure. Latitude and attitude. It's a little over 2,000 square feet of living space and 2,000 square feet of covered wraparound deck, which we'll see later. There's about 25 fruiting apple trees on the property, many different varieties, including some heirlooms. I'm in the front yard and we're closer to the home now. You can see the turnaround driveway, the home itself with its unique widow's walk on the third floor. Rose garden was just back there. And turning to the forest, as you'll see throughout this tour, not a neighbor in sight. The privacy is unquestioned. The view shed's pretty incredible too. We'll see a lot more of that later. At the veggie gardens here, they measure 70 by 100 feet. That's 7,000 square feet of organic vegetable gardens. They were enriched with loam brought up from the farm pond when it was dredged to make deeper. There's the horse run in there too. That's a great shelter for horses. We'll see more of the fields later. The garden house is 24 by 24. It has a metal roof and cedar siding, and a 10 by 12 attached greenhouse. The rose garden is up above, you can see that where we were earlier. And a small potting shed, of course, too. So we're in the home's backyard, and you can see kind of taller grasses here. This is a small stream that comes from the drilled well on site, which is an overactive well. It spurts forth water day and night, 365 days a year. It's almost bottling capacity. The amount of water at this property is really incredible. Now check this out. This is my favorite part of the grounds. Having been a high bush blueberry grower for over 10 years myself, I was absolutely blown away when I saw these plants. There's about 75, a number of varieties, and almost every single one of them was literally bowing over with fruit. These are incredible. The owners freeze about 100 quarts a year. If I get 10 quarts, I'm ecstatic. 100 quarts is insane. Look at these colors. They're different sizes and flavors. Oh, just beautiful. There's also a 75 foot by 8 foot berry patch, which includes raspberries, blackberries, and black raspberries. The owners have been cultivating these gardens for much longer than the age of the home, which was built in 2012. That's how these get to be so mature. This farm pond's a great asset. It's about 20 to 24 feet deep, depending on where you are. It really brings out the wildlife. There's peepers, nesting turtles that you'll constantly see on the property. Animals from the forest come and drink out of the pond. Really is a neat, neat attribute. You can see sort of where the lawn ends and then the fields begin. If you're a horse owner, this is an ideal property. Really is an amazing equestrian site. not only the fields and the horse run in, but the privacy, and then the 3,000 acres of woodlands that have many, many roads all throughout. Incredible. So these two wraparound porches that I spoke of earlier, 360 degrees. We'll check out the first floor wraparound porch first. You can see there's the garden house and there's the view shed. That's the Greenland Ridge that we're looking at. That view shed is entirely in conservation, a really important aspect, especially as wind power becomes more and more popular. Those French doors go into the master bedroom on the first floor, a popular amenity nowadays. So we're on the second floor wraparound porch, and we'll go the full road around. There's three sliding glass doors that lead into the great room on the second floor, which has the best views in the house. You can see Greenland Mountain and Flagstaff Mountain, which are both around 1,000 feet tall. If you get up onto the third floor, from the Widow's Walk, you can actually see Canada. It's amazing up there. If we move forward, you can see the Rose Garden, and there is a really good look at the garden house. If you enjoy being in the garden, growing your own food, being outside really, this is an incredible property. If you're into hunting, the owner here has taken his deer from his porch for a number of years. Really incredible. In fact, this property is sited within, I'm going to say it's probably the third largest deer yard in the state of Maine. It was tough to say looking at the map that Inland Wildlife and Fisheries distributes for deer yard mapping. It's definitely top five. It's probably the third or second largest deer yard in the state. And this 10 acres is right in the middle. Really an amazing location for the outdoorsman. Big turnaround driveway here. And those are more roses that are planted in the center of the cul-de-sac. And now we've almost circumnavigated the second floor deck. Incredible. Look at that view. Wow. And not a neighbor in sight. So pretty. That's a small bunkhouse right there, too. Forgot to mention that. That's a neat aspect for grandkids. Overflow guests in the summer, trust me, they'll want to come. This website has almost 100 photos, as well as a link to our comprehensive listing portfolio. But you can also call us at any time. We're happy to answer your questions. Thanks so much for checking out our video tour today. We'll see you down in Danforth.